is 30 total on each side.
Do you
want
the clips?
No, not for this.
Is a little off here. All right, so Emily is in her working sets and I am in my warm-up sets. You've done how many of your working sets?
Four.
So she's done four of her working sets. She's at
195.
195. I've been warming up while she's doing her working sets. And this should be my first working set. So this is 275 for my first single. And we're about 27, 28 minutes into the workout, from general warm-up, me starting to actually warm up the front squat. Taken almost 30 minutes to get to front squat number one for the actual workout. Nothing's more boring than a heavy day, but real life, a lot of waiting around. Would you rather do the front squats or the 400 meter repeats?
Neither.
Longer than you do.
I
appreciate your patience. That was 275 for me for the first rep. Emily's on rep number 5, I believe. 195.
let's put on the 45.
This would be working set number 2, 285 pounds, which is about, I'm thinking, 85% of my one rep max. We'll see how it feels. The 275 felt heavy. Because again, lifting charts can say whatever they want, but what a lifting chart doesn't know is I've slept like crap the last two nights. And my body feels tired. Exciting stuff. Almost another 30 seconds.
How long do you wait between?
I usually wait 2 to 3 minutes. How about you?
I don't know, but what's funny is 3 minutes feels like an eternity right now. 3 minutes did not feel long enough in those 4 minutes.
Sprints. Two more, including this?
Yes. Oh my goodness.
You're almost there. Let's put on a 10. So this will eventually be set number 3, 295. See how it feels. Is Gavin's wrist casted already?
No, he has a soft cast.
Soft cast. Our friend's son broke his wrist. So you've got one rep left.
Yes, I do.
Just waiting on me to get out of your way. Thank you. spicy. Done for the day.
I'm so sorry.
I'm so jealous. You're done. I guess two tens. No, one ten. 110.
Isn't that what you did last time?
Do you have it on there now?
No.
Put 110 on. That brings me to 295. And then I'm going to put the 5 on.
Why don't you just do the 115?
Oh, I didn't even see what happened. All right, we're going for lift number 4, 305 on the bar. I'm gonna rest another 30 seconds to a minute before I attempt it. Emily's done. I'm incredibly jealous. Sorry it's so boring, but it's a heavy day. This is like Tanner Bennett's warm-up set, or Ben over in France. This is like his warm-up set, but this is, you know, for regular humans, this is funny. Okay. A little dizzy. Okay. 305, success. I'm pretty stoked with that. I appreciate you saying that it looked light. It felt otherwise, but I'm glad it looked that way. Okay.
What do you want?
I don't know. I'm going to play around in my head for a second. Let's see. My goal for today. I was going to be very happy if I just touched 300. So that was 305. So I'm pretty darn happy. So now I'll put on 315, and we'll see if this gets stood up or decorates the floor. Well, that's how you ditch a front squat. Just let her go. Okay. What am I aiming for in the seventh set? You know, it's funny, I'm not really aiming for anything, for Greg's question. I just kind of wrote down what the, you know, what I think my percentages were based upon an estimated one rep of around 335. And so 251 was 75%, 284 was 85%. So once I got into like the 275 range, I was going to be between 80 and 85%, and I was going to be just consider those my working sets, start counting them, and just gently go up or down based upon how each set actually felt. So each set has felt certainly challenging, but safe and doable. So I've been creeping a little bit. And now it's time to try 315. Ample. How'd that look?
Good.
Okay. All right. So, my wife said that one looked good. It felt very heavy, but it did feel okay. But I don't think I'm gonna be greedy. I think I'm gonna try, that was set number 5. I'd be really happy to see if I can do that again for set 6 and again for set 7 and just get it a couple more times instead of creeping up. It's plenty heavy for today, and you know, live to fight another day. So let's see. Alright, I've been resting 90 seconds. I usually rest 2 to 3 minutes just staring at the clock to make sure I keep myself honest. Boring part of rest of heavy days. But this is why we do what we do at Linchpin, right? Like, we're not trying to cram anything else into this hour. So this will be lift number 6 out of 7. I started the clock when we started our general warm-up, you know, the head-to-toe warm-up before even the warm-up sets. And we've been in the gym now about 44 minutes. And I still have lift 6 and 7 left and cool down and stretching. And so like we always say, if you're really going to lift heavy and give it the respect that it deserves, it's going to eat up an entire hour. Okay. Feeling short change there. know that our limited equipment crew is suffering today. My heart's with you. Believe it or not, in a weird psychotic way, I actually enjoy the limited equipment option heavy days more than like a 7x1 front squat. I would actually rather do dumbbell squats and dumbbell lunges. My wife's shaking her head no. But I would say I'm 50-50 actually on when the classic heavy days come up, be it dead, squat, whatever it is, if I do them, or if I do the limited equipment option. So those limited equipment days do work really, really well for building strength, even though all you have is a set of dumbbells. When did I stop? I got about another 90 seconds of rest coming my way. And then I will be done. I will be done. Adrian, that one looked easy. I appreciate that. I truly do. It feels different in the old central nervous system. But yeah, I'm very, very happy and content with what I was hoping to hit. Based upon how I felt, how I've been sleeping the last couple of days, I'm happy with this lifting day for sure. Almost. Then it's lunchtime, which is a great time of day. Okay. Okay, won the day. That was most certainly a fight. Good day. Sets went 275, 285, 295, 305, then 315, 315, 315. And estimating my one rep, like true one rep eyes popping out of my head, at 335, so that would put, like I said, just to catch anyone up, 75% would be 251, 80%, 268, 85%, 284, 90%, 301. So I started counting my seven sets of one when I hit 275. So that was somewhere between 80 and 85% of my one rep max. And that's just, I didn't so much go off of the lifting chart, off of just during the warm-up sets to see how I felt. And my warm-up sets went, I warmed up while my wife was warming up as well, and I'd jump in, jump out, throw a little weight on there. So after I warmed up, I did the general head-to-toe warm-up. Then for the front squats, I did three at 145, two at 165, two at 185. Those are oddball jumps, but again, I was working in and out with Emily as she was lifting. Two at 225, one at 245, then my first working set at 275, because that's how the warm-up sets made me feel. And during the warm-up sets, I rest one to 2 minutes, 90 seconds, and then during my working sets, I make sure that I don't rest personally less than 2 minutes, and on the high side, 3 minutes. So that's it. Heavy day in the books. Have a great one. Tomorrow's a rest day. I encourage you to take it, and we will talk later.